some other engine. Hell, the rain's doing half the work for you.
They were people who suffered far more cruel and unusual punishment than any our penal system could even imagine.
No, I refuse to...
Let me finish.
Well.
I submit to you the issue is revenge. An eye for an eye.
I refuse to believe in any god or government which is willing to trade torture for torture, or death for death.
If your wife or child were murdered, how do you think you'd feel about that last statement of yours?
How would I feel? Very much the same as yourself. But I would not want their deaths avenged by a system as cruel and capricious as this.
Do
it's the real world.
The guy's on death row. He's asking you to put your money where your mouth is. Paul, all I'm saying is that every once in a while, you gotta get a little bloody. It's good for the soul.
So far we are online, back to 1985. Everything else before that is still on microfiche, but I can dig around the back and see what else I can find.
How long will that take?
Oh, that depends on who you are. You would be amazed at what I can do with a little help.
Thank you. outsider. So, how you like Grandma? See something else coming up on that bus like that?
Yes, she's a very determined lady. But why did you send her up to see me?
Because, Mr. Armstrong, you're from a small town like me. Fife, Scotland. First in your family to attend a university. Madden from Cambridge. Columbia Law. Youngest assistant DA, 1960-69. Joined Jackson Bowles Mannheim, 1970-1980 to the present. Harvard professor of law. Author of Process and Law. And 6 books since.
Okay.
All of which I've read.
Enough.
didn't need to once he confessed.
Did you know that he was beaten for 22 hours before he gave his confession?
So he says.
So the cuts on his hand could have been from the beating, no?
How convenient.
Armstrong?
Yes?
I'm Detective Wilcox. Spoke to you on the phone about hooking up with Tanny Brown.
Yes, G.T. Ward.
That's right. Tanny said he'd hook up with you this afternoon if you're still around. I can do for you.
Well, if you have some time later, I'll be careful.
Looks like you got a busy afternoon lined up, Mr. Armstrong.
Some people to see you.
You ever been here before?
No.
Come on. It's a nice little town. How's old Bobby Earl doing?
Oh, he's holding it together.
Holding it together. Hey, Jimmy. Yeah, I expect he would be holding it together. Cold-hearted son of a bitch. Stayed right frosty to the end. Get that vehicle back in the street, Charlie. That's the last time I'm telling you.
Sorry, JT.
And he just started spitting it out like a goddamn machine. Scared me to death.
Scared you to death.
What old Bobby Earl tell you? About that bare-ass light bulb at 4 a.m? A beat on him with a rubber hose?
Cover the phone book.
White pages or yellow pages? Mr. Armstrong? Now you listen to me. You think if I'd gotten physical with old Bobby Earl, he wouldn't be wearing my anger all over him at that arraignment? What do you think, Professor?
I'm impressed.
someone in the car and called her. She walked back. And before she got in, she...
body in the water down here and try to cover her up with some brush. Meet Joni Shriver, Mr. Armstrong. Come on, take a look.
Thank you. not that the arrested cracker happened to be a boyfriend of hers, the judge should have just thrown her out of court.
My life is different.
How was your life different after that, if the case was thrown out?
They took away my scholarship. I tell you what scholarship is for somebody like me. It's a trade-off, pure and simple. I get a free ride, I get a better image. The minute I walked into that courtroom was the minute I couldn't live up to my end of the bargain. That's all the justification they needed. It's the same way Danny Brown felt justified in looking for me when trouble came driving out.
Wait a minute. I don't follow you.
Imagine a man, a very bad man, driving a car heading south, driving off the turnpike into a choppy. He stops. He takes a siesta under a banyan tree just outside a schoolyard. Then he spots a little girl. Pretty little girl. And he talks her into his car because he's right friendly enough when he needs to be. And then he does it. Right there, in the glades, he drives on and never gives it another thought. That very bad man moves on down the line. A waitress in the Keys, two tourists in Lakeland, a prostitute in Tampa. And finally, he gets sloppy. Big time sloppy. That's where I'm going. That's the row. Death row.
He's here?
Yes. And what does he find when he gets here? A neighbor on the road who's in for what for killing a little girl. Yeah. A little blonde girl. Down in Old Choppy. All cut up and thrown in the swamps. And he says, well, boy, I know you didn't do it because I did. And he starts laughing. And he says, you must be the sorriest fuck in this unit. I can hear him, Professor. I can hear him every night.
Bargaining everything that came across my desk for 6 months. I just wanted to show the good old boys how good I was. I was hot for it. Thought I had the case locked tight. My star witness, the arresting officer. He said when he came up on the car, he found Bobby Earl on top of her in the back seat. She was screaming bloody murder. 2 seconds into cross-examination, the defense attorney produces a prom photo with my star witness in a tuxedo with the victim. Son of a bitch admits they were high school sweethearts. I didn't want to go down without a fight, so I got the judge to grant me a 24-hour recess so I could regroup. I came back with nothing. I threw the case out.
Why the hell didn't you tell me?
I did. I told you when I met you. I told you why I
left. Bullshit. You told me the night you read that letter.
I didn't.
Devil's Workshop. Do you believe in Jesus?
Yes. Yes, I do.
That's good. That's very good. I done killed so many goddamn people. I can't hardly even keep up with my correspondence, but my question is this. You think any one of those people rolled out of bed on the morning of their last day, thinking, today's my day to die? So you got to take Jesus into your heart right away, because you never know. You just never know, do you?
Even if you don't have a condition, you might have a situation.
You kill it too?
Me? No.
You never been in a war? Korea? Vietnam? Never did a little hit and run with the BMW? Never told a wife to get an abortion? That little piece of chicken you got on the side has $300 doll face getting taken care of? You got that look. You got ice in your eyes. I can tell.
Well, you're wrong.
Am I now? Mr. Armstrong. Let's see who I'm talking to here. Are you married?
Yes.
Kids?
No.
Liar. House or an apartment?
I have a house.
Alarms on the windows?
No.
Dogs?
No.
You have trouble sleeping?
No.
Liar? Afraid of dying?
I don't give it much thought.
It's three lies. Same as Peter did to Jesus for the cockroach. You ought to be ashamed of yourself lying to a condemned man.
Well done, my lies tell you as much about me as my truths. Signs.
See.
then. Oh, you saw Tyrone? Please, he is not telling you the truth. You know he's lying, because I saw him with her last night. Anyway, girl, someone's here, so I'll speak to you later. All right, then.
How you come to Blair Sullivan on this thing?
It's a long story.
Take a look around.
Where you at?
See where you are?
Man, Sullivan must have busted gut the minute he seen you coming.
What the hell is he doing now?
Captain Armstrong. There's nothing out here. You're fishing.
Justice is about to be undone.
Mr. and Mrs. Shriver, I have been wrong not to write you before this, but I've been real busy getting ready to die. I just wanted you to know what a real sweet piece of business your little baby was. Doing her was like carving up a ripe lemon, like picking ripe cherries on a summer morning, like plowing Senate's field. I did.
successful.
So, Lyle, are you single at all?
No, I've been married for 8 years.
Oh, good. It's safe for you to fool around.
All right. Champagne, anyone?
Yes.
What's your question, Trump?
here on life. So he could give me death.
Johnny Shriver.
I never had the pleasure of making that sweet little girl's acquaintance. Bobby Earl coached me a little bit on the details. All I had to do to take his crime was to tell you where that knife was hidden by that letter. You should see your face on stone. What the hell's going on up there? Why me? We needed us a legitimizer. Who's going to believe us? We're just a couple psychopaths.
But why me?
You were Bobby Earl's cow. And he had his reasons.
Reasons?
It's my turn now.
What fucking reasons?
No, it's my turn now! Come on. How did my folks look? How did they smell? Tell me everything. Come on, spare me nothing.
They said they forgive you, and they'll remember you in their prayers.
Stupid lying cocksucker, no! You inhuman bastard, you cannot cheat me of this! Let's go! Come on! We played you like a tune! It ain't over yet! You got the trials of Job ahead of you, mister! The trials of Job! The sin is pride, you motherfucker! And the messenger's revenge!
Sorry, sir, no messages.
Hey, you better lock it up, Ron. Get the keys out. Alright, we're gonna have ourselves a little ride.
Come on, Wilcox, pick up the damn phone.
just couldn't stand to see me reliving the good life, so I had to kill the fucker.
Let them go.
Not me, no. Oh, it's not you that I want, Professor.
Is it, Lori?
It's not you that I've been waiting for and thinking about for the last 8 years of my life.
But she dropped her case against you.
That isn't enough. You little lady had me held over for just one night so you can make a name for yourself off of me. Sullivan was right. The Sith is bright.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry.
I had no idea they were gonna hurt you.
Hurt me? Do you see what those fuckers did to me?
No.
They cut me. They castrated me. You feel that? You had me. Did you think those fuckers would give a shit about justice?
Thank you. Sự sám hối nơi có tội lỗi đã mang đi lời dạy của mẹ. Giờ đây con muốn trở lại với vòng tay khô cạn mà ngày bên mẹ con chẳng bận tâm. Mẹ nâng con dậy, bước con đi mẹ dõi theo từng nhịp tim đập nhanh hay chậm. Con vô tâm vô nghĩa một bước tay.
If I cannot have you and I will go, I want to have your love and I want to kiss you hard. One day you go away, one day I miss you so much. When you came to me, you said you love me. When you tend to go, you make up the story. The broken heart you brought to my life, the bitter tears of a shameful life. Why you lied to me at the day you came, and why did you give me?
We've been together too long enough. I know your soul as I know myself. You fool with me to date other guys. I know that you don't really love me. I just forgive and try to forget. Don't you really? Our faith has been